What's going on, investors? In today's video, we're gonna be going over the Bay Area real estate market update for October of 2021. If you're new to this channel, welcome. My name is Sean. I'm a real estate investor and hard money lender based in the Bay Area. And on this channel, we go over real estate investing tips, strategies, and current events to help you become a real estate investing boss. So every month, I like to go into the MLS and look at the actual statistics of the current market to see how we're doing. Is the market heating up? Is it cooling down? Or will we see a crash very soon? So in today's video, I'm going to be going over the monthly statistics for Santa Clara County, San Mateo County, San Francisco County, Alameda County, and Contra Costa County. We'll be going over the single family and condo slash townhouse markets for each of these counties. So without further ado, let's hop on in. So the first thing we're going to do is go and check out Santa Clara County and see how we're doing there for residential single family homes. All right, the first graph we look at is the average days on market and sales to list price ratio. So as we can see, the average percentage of the sales to list price ratio has gone down a little bit. So we are seeing a little bit of cooling off from the peaks of the springtime down to the summer months. And now we're here in September, where it's gone down just a little bit. And your average days on market are increasing again, just a little bit. So from 12 to 13 days, now you're at 15 days. Not a huge difference. Again, we still are in a very hot market in the Bay Area, but we are seeing a small trend where things are starting to slow down just a little bit. So if you guys are new and you haven't seen market charts like this before, don't be intimidated. These are all just common terms that people use in the industry. So this bar chart right here is your average days on market. So this signifies how long it takes for a property to go under contract once it's listed. So if an agent puts a property under contract on a Wednesday and it gets under contract the next Wednesday, then the days on market for that one property is 7 days. So if you look at all the properties in Santa Clara County for the month of September of 2021, that average is 15 days, which is still very, very good. And this one right here, your sales to list price ratio, this one is around 108%. So this just means that if you list a property at a certain price, then it'll go on average for around 108% of that original listing price. So basically, if you see a property listed for $1 million, there's a good chance that it won't sell for $1 million. It'll probably sell for $1,080,000. All right, next we're gonna look at the months of inventory. So as you can see here, the months of inventory are slowly creeping up, but again, it's still very low. It's under 1 month. So what this statistic signifies is how long it'll take for all the properties in this area to sell out if it continues selling at its current pace with its given inventory. So with the given inventory we have now and selling at a certain rate, we're gonna sell all the properties in Santa Clara County in 1 month. All right, checking out sales price over time, we can see that the sales price has increased a little bit from last month, but still not as high as it was back in June of 2021. But it's still pretty impressive to see that average homes in Santa Clara County are going for $2 million. And another statistic that we look at is the number of homes for sale versus sold. So as you can see here, we have more properties that are sold every month than properties are actually still on the market. And again, this signifies this dynamic shift between sellers and buyers. In this case, so many properties are being sold that sellers have most of the power in this transaction of homes. And this is not always true where you have more properties sold than properties on the market. And usually when you have this happening, it just shows that sellers are in control here and sellers have the ability to basically put whatever price they want. But as a trend, we do see that there is less properties being sold month over month, whereas you know, the properties that are on the market are kind of increasing a little bit, especially since the beginning of this year. So who knows, maybe in the future, this bar chart could invert and we'll have more properties on the market than are being sold. Again, this does show a small softening in the market, but nothing quite significant where you need to worry too much. All right, so let's do the same stuff for the condos and townhouse market for Santa Clara County. And we can see here that it's been flat since last month. Your days on market have increased just a little bit by 2 days. So again, nothing too crazy here. So if we look at the months of inventory here, we can see that the months are around the same. It's around 1 month. Number of homes for sale versus sold. And as you can see here, this is very different from the single family market. We actually have more properties here that are active than properties that are being sold. But since they're even, it means that there's basically a similar balance shift between buyers and sellers here. But as you can see last year, there were more properties that were active that were actually sold. So in this case, we had more properties on the market than buyers. And so buyers actually had the power in this transaction. And so they could offer really, really favorable terms for them. All right, and looking at sales prices, sales price have gone down just a little bit. Just a little bit. All right, next we're gonna check out San Mateo County single family homes. So now we're looking at the average days on market and sales to list price ratio for San Mateo County for single family homes. The sales to list price ratio has gone down a little bit as well, probably by about 1%. And now we also have a little bit longer for the days on market here. months of inventory have increased by just a little bit, but again, hovering around 1 month, so it's still a very favorable market for sellers. And with the number of homes for sale versus sold, we have an inversion here. We have a little bit more properties that are on the market than have been sold. So I guess properties in San Mateo County are taking more time than usual to sell. But if we look at the sales price over time, it looks like it has recovered a little bit from its slump in August, but still not at its peak in June of 2021. So basically, the springtime of 2021 was very hot. If you remember, the market was absolutely bonkers. And then since June, it has gone down a little bit, and now it's slowly recovering. This is normal. It's part of the seasonality of the Bay Area market. Usually spring is very hot, then summer lows a little bit, and then the fall goes up a little bit, and then winter it dies down. So if you want to get a good deal in the Bay Area, it could be worth your while to just wait a little bit before getting into the market in November and December. All right, so now we're going to look at the statistics for San Mateo County condos and townhouses. As you can see here, we actually had an increase in pricing here. Our sales to list price ratio has increased to 105%, and our days on market have remained relatively flat here as well. Our months of inventory have also remained pretty flat, and now we're at 1.5 months. All right, look at the number of homes for sale versus sold. You can still see that there's more properties on the market than are being sold, but obviously not as bad as it was last year. Like last year, if you want a condo in San Mateo County, you could have your pick and you could have it at an amazing price. And we can see here that the average prices have gone down just a little bit. We're now at about $1 million on average for sale prices in San Mateo County. All right, so let's move along to San Francisco County for single family homes. Okay, so let's see. Days on market have decreased by a little bit, and your average sales to list price ratio has gone up to 116%. So that's pretty cool. Like, people are, I guess, are listing low and are expecting to get 115% or higher on their listings. If we look at the months of inventory, it has actually gone up a little bit, and now we're at 2 months. So it's kind of weird, right? Where it looks like the number of homes for sale versus sold, the ratio isn't that great, right? Like, condos in SF haven't been doing good for the past year. It's recovered a little bit since, you know, this was really bad, right? Now it's a little bit lower. But you still have this discrepancy. We have almost 2 times the amount of properties that are still active than are actually being sold. It is interesting though that your sales to list price ratio is higher. So what I think is people are just putting the prices down lower and lower. So if we look at the sales price over time, the sales price has increased at 2.5 million here, but now it's going down to a little under 2. So for single family housing, it's very strange where you have more properties on the market than are actually being sold. They take long to sell, and they're selling for over $2 million. And yet, when they do sell, people are often overbidding. You know, they're putting 15% over asking, even though people don't want the property. So maybe it just means that sellers are just like hesitant to sell unless they're getting the price that they want. They probably have enough equity, they don't mind waiting, and so they don't have to sell, they don't need to. All right, let's look at condos and townhouses. So for condos and townhouses, the average days on market have remained relatively similar at 34 days, so they're not really moving very quickly. And you're getting around 105%. For your average sales to list price ratio. Months of inventory here, they have spiked. So now we're at 4 or 5 months. So yeah, condos are doing really bad here. And yeah, as you can see here, you have way more properties that are active than are actually being sold. And so getting a condo at this time may be a good idea if you plan on holding it for a long term. And look at the sales price over time, it's remained relatively flat throughout all of 2021, just hovering at $1.4 million. All right, let's look at Alameda County average days on market and sales to list price ratio. So Alameda County is actually going down, which is surprising. So as you can see before, Alameda County was just a rising star, every month going higher and higher and higher. And now it's finally coming back down to reality. We're at around 112%, which is in line with what we saw with Santa Clara County. And your average days on market is also increasing a little bit. So now we're at 15 days. All right, properties are slowing down a little bit. So before we were at half a month, now we're at 1 month. But so it's still a very hot market for Alameda County. The number of homes for sale versus sold, like last year, was crazy, right? Look at all these giant green peaks here. But now you have more and more inventory, okay? And you have less and less properties being sold. So this is, again, showing a slowdown in the market. And your sales price looks like it's going down by a little bit as well. All right, so now we look at the average days on market and sales to list price ratio for condos and townhouses in Alameda County. And we can see that this is also going down. It's just a trend of the average sales to list price ratio is going down and your average days on market is going up. Your months of inventory are also slowly creeping up as well, month over month. If you look at the number of homes for sale versus sold, we can see that we had this little inversion where we had more properties on the market than being sold. So slowly but surely, we're seeing less and less properties actually being sold. We have more and more properties going on the market. So this inversion is going to cause that slowdown. and your sales price is also going down, but not by too much. So we're around $700,000 or so. All right, let's see what's going on with Contra Costa County. So with Contra Costa County, unfortunately, there was a glitch last month, so we can't use this chart. We have to look at the actual data for it. So this month, we were at 106.1%, which is lower than the trends we were seeing before. So since February, it's been above that number, and it kind of went up, and then now it's going down. Your average days on market have also increased by a little bit, so now we're at 15 days. And look at the chart, it looks like it's going up to 1 month, so not too bad. Number of homes for sale versus sold. Same, right? We're seeing less properties being sold and more properties being put on the market. So right now, everything's pretty even. Whereas if you looked at springtime, there were way more properties being sold than were on the market. So if you were looking for a house in the spring of this year, you knew it was really hard to get a property. Now it's a little bit easier. So maybe wait a few more months and it'll be really easy to go in and get your property. And the sales price over time is also slowly decreasing as well. Don't worry about this number. Right now we're filming on the 1st of October. So this is a glitch number. But you can see here, it's slowly going down here as well. All right, finally, we're gonna look at the condo and townhouse market for Contra Costa County. Ooh, look at this, look at this. There's a rise and then there's a fall. So now your average sales to price ratio is going down to 103% and your days on market have increased 18 days. Months of inventory is also climbing up by a little bit and the number of homes for sale versus sold are also kind of decreasing here. So it's interesting, like it looks like the total number of properties, whether it be active or sold, is kind of going down, kind of together. And we can see the sales price has increased by just a little bit. Just a little bit. So that was the Bay Area monthly market update for October of 2021. And as you can see, it's very apparent that there is a slowdown in the market, but you know, obviously it doesn't mean that there's a crash coming on. Like I said earlier in the year, when markets are very high like this, they're gonna peak and boom up during the springtime, and then they'll probably come back down during the fall. And that's what we're seeing right now, where prices are reverting back to what they were in the early spring. So if you ever bought the top, then it sucks for you if you're flipping the property. But if you're planning on holding it long term, it's not going to be an issue at all. Normally with seasonality, the real estate market is very hot during the spring, slows down a little bit during the summer, picks back up during the fall, and then slows down again during the winter. So if you're looking for a property in the Bay Area, I highly encourage you guys to wait maybe one or two more months. If you're looking for a property in November, then you'll likely get a much better deal than competing with everyone else during the peak times that the real estate market is booming. Personally, I'm doing that. I'm planning on buying a property in Texas over the next few months, and I plan on buying it in the wintertime because there's not as many people buying and competing with me at that same time. But let me know your thoughts. Do you think the market is going to continue to increase? Will it slow down? Or do we have a crash that's imminent? Let me know your thoughts down in the comment section below. And if you guys have enjoyed this video, I encourage you guys to smash like button and subscribe to the channel to see more videos just like this one. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time. Take care.